Ronnie Jones and the Cusack.
Ronnie Jones and the Cusack was like a continuation of Malcolm McGarrahan and the Blues Healers, who I met actually. This is quite interesting because I was in the Skyliners and discovered in the Skyliners, we did an audition for someone in the West End, and there was a guy there called Samwell who wrote Move It for Cliff Richard, you know? And he was then managing bands. This is in the 60s, mid 60s, and he kind of discovered me, and so he wanted me to join this soul band. So me and Mitch Mitchell, who was a
Hendrix drummer,
drummer who eventually went on to be famous for Jimi Hendrix Experience. Me and Mitch went along for the audition. We both afterwards said, don't think we want to do this. We both decided we didn't want to be in the band, but I did eventually end up 9 months later joining Malcolm McGarrahan and the Blues Seals as a soul band.
Is this the outfit that you played Bag and Hours with Residency?
That was Ronnie Jones, but it was this, or was it Malcolm? I can't remember. No, it was Ronnie Jones and the Cusack.
Right, so, yeah. I mean, the Bag of Nails, I remember, because the Gunnell brothers.
That's right, yeah.
Because we were invited down there once to have a look, but...
Rick and Johnny.
How many times did Hendrix jumped up and played with you
there? Oh, loads of times. It was when he first came over to England from the States. He was brought over here by Chaz Chandler of the Animals. Big guy. There's another story about Chaz, I could tell you. And we were the resident band at the Bag of Nails. We played there. It was great, you know. It was a wage for a start. That's how I gave up work, see, because I turned professional, you know. I was 18.
That's amazing. I probably saw you there because we had to go down a couple of times. And, you know, amazing, really. Mm. About 1969?
No, 70? Before that. Was that? Before that. It was 60... Well, let's see, I think more like 67.
Did you 67. Ever play the Speakeasy?
Yeah, loads of times. Loads of times.
And at that time, wasn't the Ram Jam Club in Brixton going? Did you play that?
Yeah, played the Ram Jam Club, yeah.
And that was Georgie Fame, the Blue Flames played there. That you played
there? And Georgie Fame, Blue Flames, and also... Georgie Fame used to play the Flamingo in the
Flamingo,
in was it Wardour Street?
Yeah.
Mm. Well, upstairs there was the Whisky Agogo. Before I went,
and you were playing at all these places, the Flamingo.
Not the Whisky. Me and my mate Don used to go to the Whisky to try and get women, but we were very young. I was only about 15 at the time. Shouldn't have been in there really.
Yeah. I did see there's a clip on YouTube of. We're going jumping a bit of a rival on Top of the Pops.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And there's you on piano, and you look like about 16, across between Brian Jones and somebody else.
I was 20. I think I was 20.
20 then.
Was I 20? No. When was that? 17? No, 21.
When I spoke to Neil Hubbard, your guitarist in Kokomo, about that, he said, "Yeah, Tony in those days, always pulling, and all the girls fancied him." And I said to Neil, "Well, yeah, we were all like that in the old days, weren't we?"
Were you?
I went too far then, but that's good.
That's all right.
Oh, Mick Cox band. Yeah.
You
Arrival. So we're coming on to Arrival.
Okay. Arrival. Yeah. Well, okay. Arrival. Well, what happened? I was on the books of the Gunnells, playing with Ronnie Jones. Then the Counts with Philip Chen, who a bass player Philip, who went on to play with. Rod Stewart, among other people. He's actually doing Doors now. He's working with the Doors. And Philip's great, fantastic. That was with a band called The Counts, which was an offshoot of the band Jimi, James and the Vagabonds. Remember?
Yeah.
They were very, very famous for that, you know, for that era, soul music, you know. And Philip, anyway, was in that band. And it was great. It was the Counts, and it was Count Suckle who had been in Jimmy James and the Vagabonds. And Count was more like the MC. He sang as well, but he was more like the MC. Go on, brilliant Suckle, man. chat. It was great. It was, and a singer, Tony, I think it was his name as we go through. And then, yeah, me and Philip became like that. We became very close buddies. We wanted to, you know, improve our musicians. We were musicianship. We were only young, you know, young guys, 18. We wanted to, you know, we wanted to be great musicians, and that's what we talked about all the time, was just becoming.
So great. The Gunnell set you up to play with a rival? I know that Frank...
I'm waffling on about music, aren't I? And that's not very interesting, is
Frank
it?
Frank Collins and Dyan Birch came down from Liverpool.
You know what I've noticed?
The problem is, because we've got to cram this all into 5 minutes.
5 minutes? Well, you have to do some editing. I know, what upsets me is that people actually aren't really interested in music.
But you're only 20 at the moment still. We've got to get up, move on.
Yeah, but I thought we had all day.
No, carry on. So
I think you'll have a load of outtakes.
Oh, Mick Cox we missed, didn't we?
And no, we haven't got, that's after Mick Cox. He comes after.
See? Oh, after arrival, right.
Yeah. So we're at arrival, are we?
We've arrived at arrival.
Okay. I was on the Gunnell's books as a musician, playing with the Counts, you know, with Philip Chen. I thought it was just important to mention the fact that although we were being... you know, we were in bands and having a great time. We were very serious about music, about improving ourselves. And, you know, especially with Philip, who's one of the first guys that I'd met who, you know, was determined to become a great musician.
Not pop, but a musician.
Yeah, as a musician. Yeah, you know, just to live the life as a musician. Mm. And so that was important to me, meeting Philip and Philip Chen. Who we still in contact now, he's in LA. still hustling for them gig, innit? So, I was on the books of the Gunnells and got a call one day saying, look, there's some singers from Liverpool in town. You know, can you go down and do an audition? There's Mac from the Chevelles, he's on bass, and a drummer called Mick Huff who's going to join, you know, see what. And there was these four singers from Liverpool, fresh from Liverpool, two girls, two guys. And they started to sing and it was a dream. It was fantastic. Always thought, bloody hell, this is singing, you know. And I'd never heard it, especially live, in front of me, four beautiful voices. And I was immediately hooked, especially Dyan looked great. She was young, 19 or something. Singing like an angel. And Frank, that's Dyan Birch, by the way, Frank Collins, and Paddy mchugh, and Carroll Carter. And they were a rival. And they'd come down from Liverpool, and the Gunnells had picked up on them. So, you know, we said, this is great, me and Mac from the Chevelles, and we said, yeah. And a gig was set up at Ronnie Scott's. I think this was February.